Hello friends, now I am going to start to discuss the last fundamental right. Actually earlier five topics we have completed and this is the sixth point, right to constitutional remedies. Okay, actually this is a protection for the other fundamental rights. Carefully understand me. This is protection of other fundamental rights, and if any of the other fundamental rights are not properly given to us as the citizen, then we have this right. So that as per the constitution we can file a writ application in a Supreme Court for a violation of our fundamental right. Means you understand me very clear that we can ask that our specific right is not given to us, and Supreme Court plays an important role for implementing our protection of fundamental right. If any right is breached, no problem. We have this sixth right to protect our other five rights. And if court or the Supreme Court or the apex court finds that it is necessary to re-establish our specific right, then it can be given us. They can issue orders, they can pass the orders, they can issue notice, they can give instructions, whatever, or they can pass decree. Decree means the order for the purpose of re-establishment of our specific right. In that way, all powers are vested in Constitution, and Constitution has given that power to re-establish our specific breach right. So it is called protection of fundamental right has been done by this sixth right for constitutional remedies. So if it is required, Supreme Court or the apex court can exercise this right against any person, any group, any community or any state administration for violation of our specific right. So it is a duty of that administration to re-establish our rights. Here we have to remember one statement of Baba Saheb Ambedkar, that it is soul of constitution. Dr. Ambedkar had said that the sixth right is the soul of the constitution, because if this right is not given, then there is no meaning of other five rights. Because if any breach has happened, then who will protect? So this is the sixth right has been given. So in that way, if any law has been framed and if it is violating the fundamental right, then such law can also repealed, cancelled, cannot implement by the order of Supreme Court. So the right provides us an opportunity to approach court for violation of fundamental right and can request to the apex court to re-establish that breaching of or violation of right. So the Constitution is providing us as the citizen our rights. Also, it is required to be taken in mind that fundamental rights are applicable to every person, and if in situation of any circumstances, emergency or crisis conditions, our fundamental right generally could for some time restricted if it is required, but generally neither any state have a right to form law which violate our fundamental right. Is that clear, my friends? So here I have tried to indicate and discuss fundamental rights. Here the point which I explained about Ambedkar Sahib, it is important to remember for one line question, right? Okay, now we are moving to the next topic, fundamental duties. See, there is a one line is given. We have already studied by our childhood that even myself as a student when I was, we have studied that rights and duties are two sides of one coin. Means if we want to see that our right must be implemented properly, then we must follow our duties. It is also required to be taken in mind. Otherwise, our rights cannot be implemented properly. Because if we want to see that the rights should be followed, then which duties we have followed is also required to see. Here we have to keep in our mind that we can go to the courts to establish our fundamental right. And in case of fundamental duty, courts will listen also the government that that is the breach of the duty the citizen has done. So it is also not possible that we breach the duty, we not follow our duty and we expect the fundamental right. It is not possible. For both the side, it is required to follow. Is that clear? The people of India were aware for their rights and duties. Generally, it is a possible and everybody follow it. As the citizen, we have given our rights. So, Constitution has incorporated some duties. But remember, the rights were included by the same day of implementation of Constitution in 1950. But the duties have been included in the Constitution in 1976. This is also one single one line question that by which year the duties, fundamental duties have been incorporated in the Constitution of India. The fundamental duty aims, this is also one line question, aims to inculcate love for the nation, वेरी केयरफुली लिसन व्हाट एम्स फंडामेंटल ड्यूटी इनकलकेट लव फॉर द नेशन अटेंशन फॉर द नेशनल इंटीग्रिटी values the high ideals and value the awareness among the citizens for the other citizens. That is aimed for the incorporating fundamental duties in the constitution. By this way, we can help our administration to develop our nation. Every citizen of India should contribute in their own way towards the protection of national unity. See, these things we have to worry, we have to care, and we have to think about the national unity, integrity, and sovereignty of nation. Sometimes the students forget the meaning of the sovereignty. Sovereignty is indicating that in the issue regarding relation with the other countries and required decisions, the government of the nation is completely supreme for taking the appropriate decision. For that point of view, we have not to consult with the external supreme power of other nations. It means our country is completely independent to take the appropriate decision. It is called sovereignty. So that the peace, security, communal harmony could remain in the nation within the all communities and classes of citizens. So, the fundamental duties are required to be followed by us. We all need to follow these fundamental duty without any obstacle. We need to follow. And these fundamental duties have been given in our educational textbook of every year, every standard on the beginning pages. Also before or after pledge. Here I am indicating these 11 fundamental duties. But before that, I want to explain some other additional topic. Before I start these 11 duties, I want to indicate some other importance. The 6th January, every year, is celebrated in India as the Fundamental Duty Day. You can understand why it is to create the awareness in citizens about following fundamental duties. The person violate it, if any person violate it, it means fundamental duty. He should be punished as per the law. It is our duty. It is a duty in term of the legal and moral as well as the responsibility as a citizen that social evils and evil customs which are prevailed in the society should be removed. Now we can understand which social evils I want to say. Untouchability is the social evil. Druggery, to carry the waste on the head in front of the people, pass on the public roads, it is an insult. Druggery, child labor, women exploitation, dowry. Dowry means to take the money from the parents of bride at the time of marriage by the parents of groom, or even if the groom is asking for the money at the time of marriage or any time from the bride's parents or even from the bride, it is illegal. It is called dowry, because for the reason of dowry, lots of the brides are losing their lives. It is very cruel thing to kill the wife for asking the money. Very bad thing. So the dowry is prohibited. Thereafter, female forticide in the womb of mother, if it is decided that girl, then the family of the boy will start to kill the unborn child. It is called female forticide. Thereafter, ill customs, illegal customs, customs activities, superstitions which are not actually proved, but in the blind belief of the person, it is called superstitions. By the religion, it is followed. So the duties are to remove these evil customs, ill customs, and these wrong activities. So the duties are given us to follow and to make us as the sensible, well aware citizen for the establishment of better society in India. If the citizen understand the importance and follow the duties, then the future citizens will also develop their life with the intention to be national responsible citizen. And we can create our brotherhood with the other citizens in country as well as the other country. We can create exploitation free and just society. It is required to follow by us. So here I want to indicate very clearly that to make the person just, aware citizen, law-binding citizen, then to make him aware about our fundamental duties, we need to follow these duties. Remember, okay, here now I am going to start these 11 duties. Here, which date I explained in front of you just in this lecture, try to remember. 6th January is celebrated as Fundamental Duty Day in India. Remember this date. It is a one single one line question. Okay. Let's continue with the 11 points of the fundamental duties. The first point, abide by Constitution and respect its ideals and institution as well as the national flag and national anthem. We need to respect all these things. Again, I repeat, abide by Constitution and respect ideals and the national institutions, national flag and national anthem. You know our national anthem is Jana Gana Mana, right? Remember. Next, to cherish and follow noble ideals which inspired our national freedom struggle. We have to understand this, because without sacrifice of our freedom fighters, we were unable to be free from the clutch of Britishers. So we need to follow noble ideals which was in mind and heart of our national freedom fighters. Okay. The third point is uphold, means establish and protect sovereignty, unity and integrity of India. We have to make our country united. We have to show the sovereignty of our nation to the world. And we have to take the steps through which our country remain integrate with each other. No division could develop. In these days, we see the situation on the base of the classes, on the base of the religion, on the base of the extreme mindset. So many differences are seen. But ultimately, remember that our nation is united and integrate with each other. Whatever the reason of clashes, but neither any clash is creating problem for our nation, because the most of the citizens are aware about the national interest, right? The fourth point is defend the country, means protect the country, render services where and when called upon to do so. Render means give the national services when the nation needs us. We not need to show to the world that I am doing a service for the nation. No. But we need to do what we are doing for our parents. We are trying to be there for them. The same way, when the nation needs us, we cannot ask for the money only. Because some things in the world are not purchased by the money. Remember, so the identity of the nation is also come to us by our birth. It cannot be earned by money. Okay, so many people says that we can get the green card of any country, but it does not mean that you are citizen of that nation by birth. But with which country you show your sovereignty, your integrity to the nation, that shows that you are citizen of that country. In that way, when the country needs our service, we have to be there for our service to do for the nation. We have not to ask for money also. The fifth point is promote harmony, means connect the country, and promote the spirit of common brotherhood, means we all are from the same family. That intention is required to spread among all the people. Transcending religious, linguistic, regional and sectional diversities. We have to cross these diversities and we have to connect the nation and renounce practices derogatory to the dignity of women. We have to try to establish the dignity of women. We have to support to the women, because the womanhood is the ultimate required for the existence of world. If we think that the women is not required, then it is the most blundered of our thinking, because women is the center of the existence of the world, and we not give the dignity to the women, then our society is truly uncivilized. So we need to give dignity to the women. We have to respect the womanhood of the world. Also, I want to indicate one more point, that religious, linguistic, regional and sectional diversities, means we have to respect all divisions. We should not think that only we are in the country and we have only right, we the only have right to exist in the nation. No, it is not possible. We are ultimate connected with the nation for the existence of nation, to develop the nation. But we can't say that we are the only single person. So, we have to respect everyone. The sixth point is value and preserve the rich heritage. This is the most important thing. If the country wants to exist, they have to preserve their past and our heritage means whatever is given to us by our fathers, our forefathers, our ancestors. What they have given to us is the heritage for us, and if we not preserve our past, our future will not be exist. So remember, for our existence of the nation, our heritage is required to be preserved. It is required to do by us. The seventh point is protect and improve natural environment. We have to protect our environment because forests, lakes, rivers, wildlife and other living creatures are required to exist. Without them, our existence is nothing. So to protect the environment, we can see the global warming now. Why it is happening? Because the cutting the trees is the dangerous thing has happened with us. So we need to destroy, we need to stop this destruction. So we need to protect our environment, and that we do by preserving our biodiversity, preserving our wildlife, preserving our forest, preserving our rivers. Means our geographical biodiversity, our geographical diversity is with us, then it create the best environment for us, and that we need to preserve. The eighth point is develop the scientific temper. Temper means ideology, humanism and spirit of inquiry and reform. See, earlier I said that we not follow the blind beliefs and superstitions. That is the concept of scientific approach. Accept everything, but after making yourself sure about its existence. If someone say that death is a miracle, but all miracles are truly reality of the world. It does not need to create the blind belief, but accept any change with scientific understanding. So neither any person could follow any superstitions. So the scientific temper is required to develop in the mind of the people. So the blind belief cannot spread out on the religious basis, and any religion could not be spoiled. Ninth point, safeguard the public property and abjure. Abjure means stop the violence. If the public property is not there, where will we go? What do you mean by public property? Think about roads, public buildings, street lights, bus stations, airports, railway stations, railway tracks. Everything is the public property, on not on the name of any person's own ownership, individual ownership. It is public property, and public property is constructed, prepared or developed by hard money of the people, what they have paid to the taxes, as the taxes. So we need to save all this public property because it is made from our hardly earned money, right? Means it is for all. Okay, the 10th point is strive towards excellence in all spheres of individual and collective activity so that the nation constantly rise means uplift to higher level of endeavor and achievement. See, in all spheres means all divisions of the society, for the individual way or the collective efforts. So the complete nation develop in all the way, and we can achieve our required powers. Means our attention for the existence of the nation, development of the nation, upliftment of the nation is only possible by our own efforts. And the last point is, parent or the guardian has to provide opportunity to educate their child between minimum age of 6 to 14 years. Means neither any person could create the situation for their kids, so he or she must bound to go to earn money, because this age of 6 to 14 is to become the educate for being the future aware citizens and responsible citizens in the nation. Right, my friends? So here I am completing fundamental duties in complete elaboration. Okay, my friends?